Welcome to this short two-part video series on how to support the development of your young child's mathematical mind. In this first video, we're going to talk about what the mathematical mind is, and I'm going to give you some very fun and easy suggestions to integrate into your home to help and support the development of your child's mathematical mind. In the second video, I'm going to talk about mathematical concepts. And again, I'm going to give you some fun, easy activities that you can use in your home to help your child with understanding of mathematical concepts. Let's talk about how the mathematical mind works. It is working through curiosity, and it's working through observation, seeing relationships, sequencing and patterns, and making advanced classifications and abstractions. Now, we're not talking about math as in math facts. We are talking about these characteristics that develop our capacity to understand mathematics and to understand those patterns and relationships around us in life. I want to give you some activities that are easy to incorporate that are going to help support your child's mathematical mind. Let's start with curiosity. A great question to prompt a little curiosity is, I wonder what would happen if. Many children don't need this, but sometimes we have a child who's reluctant to explore and push the boundaries just a little bit, especially if maybe we're outside and we're playing with dirt and water and we're making mud. I wonder what would happen if you added a lot of water to your mud. Prompt that exploration. We can have a similar type of exploration when we're doing baking, adding the dry ingredients to the wet ingredients, and you do it very slowly, right? If your child gives you that question, I wonder what would happen if. As long as it's an appropriate activity, let them find the answer to that question. This is their genuine curiosity blooming. Sometimes curiosity takes the form of taking things apart. And this is excellent to find out how things work. I loved having a flashlight in my classroom when I was a teacher. To be able to take the parts of the flashlight apart and put it back together was amazing for the child. And then to flip that switch to see if the light would turn on or off. This is genuine curiosity and is one of those components, those characteristics of a healthy mathematical mind. Another characteristic of that mathematical mind we can support is observation, learning how to see. Now, children are already very keen observers, and we can help guide some of that observation too. Nice way to do that is to plant seeds. Once the seeds sprout, put a little popsicle stick next to the seed sprout, and every day let your child mark how tall that seedling is as it grows. You can watch cookies rise in the oven. I wonder why they rise in the oven. Look at how they change from the dough to the cookie. We can watch the shadows move. We can take some sidewalk chalk and trace the outline of a shadow a couple times a day. You can see how that shadow moves. How about watching the clouds? When was the last time you laid down and just watched the clouds with your child? This is amazing observation. And often the first time that children see clouds moving and changing shape is when they stop and they observe. Estimating is another quality of this mathematical mind that is really easy to support in the home. Just by allowing your child to help in preparing some of their own snacks or food for the day. Pouring their own drinks, they're using estimation. How much am I going to pour in? When do I stop pouring so my cup doesn't overfill? Pouring bowls of cereal, spreading nut butter on crackers or bread. How much is too much? How much is not enough? This is that quality of estimation. Rolling a ball is another fun activity where the child can engage in some estimation. So you would sit on the floor and roll gently, roll a ball back and forth. You can Lengthen the distance between the two of you. Shorten the distance between the two of you. So the child is really having to think about the pressure that they're exerting on the ball to get it to meet your hands. This is a super easy and fun one for estimation. Seeing patterns and creating patterns is another characteristic of the mathematical mind that is really easy to support. You can do simple bead stringing. Start a pattern and have your child finish it. Or your child can come up with their own pattern that they're beading. You can go outside with the sidewalk chalks and make patterns with shapes or with different colors on the concrete. Clapping games are an incredible way to reinforce patterns. Clapping games are you come up with a pattern and then your child claps the pattern back. Then they clap out a pattern and you clap it back. You can incorporate your whole body. You can be doing clapping hands. You can be stomping your feet. You can use your whole body for this. And doesn't that sound fun? Like a perfect activity to do inside or even outside in the sunshine with your child. Making judgments is a characteristic of the mathematical mind that is really easy to support in the home. You could be doing puzzles with the child, and there are levels of puzzles for really almost any age of child. Helping feed the animals in your home, if you have, let's say, a dog or a cat, filling up those food bowls so that there isn't too much in the bowl, but there's just the right amount for the pet for the day. Even feeding the fish, that pinch of the fish food, you can't put too much in the water. You can only put just a little bit. That making judgments is so nice to do, especially if you have some pets. Even watering the plants. You put too much water on a plant and it gets very soggy. The plant could wilt. You've got a drip plate that is full of water. Sorting is another one that's really easy to put together. You could put together a variety of different pasta shapes for your child to sort out into the ones that are maybe the same color or the same shape. You could put together buttons. They can again sort them by size, shape, by color, by how many little buttonholes they have for stitching the thread through. Anything that a child can sort is great. If they like tools, put together some nuts and bolts of different sizes for them to sort and to put together. So I hope that I have offered you some fun, simple activities that have inspired you to create your own and get a little creative with the types of things that are supportive of your young child's mathematical mind. In the next video, we're going to talk about mathematical concepts and how you can build in some supports for those, because school is not the only place where we can learn these types of mathematical concepts.